Hey guys, welcome back to Learn Etiquette Tutorials. In this video, I am going to show you how to extend or increase EBS volumes that is already provisioned to Kubernetes pods. My containerized application is running on AWS and I am using EKS service. In order to perform this task, you must have knowledge on Kubernetes resources like deployments, persistent volume and claims. Related links are mentioned in the description, please make use of it. Before getting to the topic, just a small request to those who are watching this video for the first time from my YouTube channel. We have already uploaded a lot of videos related to Ansible, Docker, AWS, Kubernetes and other technologies too. Please have a look. If you are interested in learning, then do subscribe now and click nearby bell icon for more interesting and useful videos. Let's get started. I am just logged into my machine where I have installed kubectl to manage my Kubernetes cluster. And this is the output of my existing persistent volume and persistent volume claim. So I have only one EBS volume provisioned to my Kubernetes pods through persistent volume claim, that is 2GB, and storage class type is GP2. Let me show you my running pods. I have only two pods running on this developed namespace. Let me put describe command to pods so that I will be able to check my existing mount point and volumes. So this volume is mounted on /temp and /data. Let's log into my first pod and put df-h command to see mounted partitions. So I could see all my mounted volumes, including the 2GB volume that is mounted on /temp/data. And this is the volume we are going to resize now from 2GB to 4GB. Even on my AWS console, I could see only 2GB existing EBS volume. So before resizing the volume, first thing you have to check which storage class are you using in your PVC. Kubectl get se. This command will give you the list of storage classes available in your Kubernetes cluster. Currently, I have only one type, that is GP2, and this is the default one I am using right now. Doesn't matter how many storage class type you have. What storage class are you using in your PVC? You have to only check on that particular storage class type. So I am using the default GP2 storage class type. Now, second thing you have to note here is, does your storage class type supports for volume expansion? Currently, it is in false state, which means your storage class is not supporting for volume expansion. So we have to change this to true. Let me edit this storage class to change this volume from false to true. Kubectl edit SE and the SE name. Check for the option called allow volume expansion. If you couldn't find, just add an entry. Let me add it in the last line, allow volume expansion colon true. Done. Save and exit from here and check the status again. Now the volume expansion is changed to true, which means your storage class will support now for volume expansion. Then open your PVC resource and change the size as you prefer. Let me only put 4GB here. Just apply this resource now. Kubectl apply-pvc.yaml. Let's check the status of PVC. It is still showing 2GB. New change is not reflected. It will be reflected only when your pod gives the request for the claims. So in my case, already my pods are running. So I am going to delete one pod just to give a request claim signal. Or what you can do is you can scale down or scale up your replicas if you want. Anything would be fine. Just I wanted to refresh the claims. So deleted. Again, check the status of pods. Both pods are running fine now. Let me log into the pod which is created newly. Put df-h. Did you see the volume size is increased to 3.9 GB, which is 4 GB, and this is what we want. Log out from this part and log into the other part just to verify the volume size. Here it is automatically changed. So what about my PVC status? Earlier it was showing only 2 GB. Now that is also changed to 4 GB. Let's check on AWS consolant. It is showing only 2 GB. Let me refresh the page. It is changed. So we have successfully resized our volumes, which is provisioned already to parts. Hope you have got an idea how to do that. First thing, check what type of storage class are you using in your PVC. Second thing, does your storage class support for volume expansion? Then finally, change the volume size on PVC and just apply it. If the new size is not reflected, just do some scale up or scale down. That's it. See you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing and have fun.
How did you feel? Is it helpful? Appreciate our efforts in the comment section below. Hit like button, share with your friends about us, subscribe our channel to get further updates. Stay connected with us on social networking sites. For more free tutorials, visit our website www.lanityguide.net.